I got my Canadian permanent resident in 4 months without any help of an immigration lawyer, and I want to share with you 7 tips how I did it. Hey, my name is Olar. I was born in Estonia, living in Canada, and my permanent residence was through common law sponsorship. Yours might be a little bit different, but these tips can still be helpful. Before we start, please keep in mind that those tips are based on my experience. As every one of us is different, so are our applications and the requirements for them. I'm not an immigration lawyer, and you are a smart, capable human being. Use this video as an introduction and then go out and look up for yourself and confirm all the bureaucratic details that you have to do to get the permanent residence. 1. Sources of information. Your best friend will be the immigration section of Canada's website. There, you can look up the specific requirements for your country, and it's all nicely explained how you can go about collecting them. In my case, I looked up the requirements for Estonia, as I am from Estonia. Then, join the Facebook group of your country folk in Canada. Mine was called Eestlased Kanadas, what means Estonians in Canada. It will be a time and money saver, since many people in the group have already applied for their permanent residence in their past and they have gotten it. They can help you out with specific questions you have. Thanks to that group, I saved money and a full day trip to the capital because it wasn't really necessary. But I thought it was. Also, helpful is to read through the Canada Visa Forum. You can find all types of questions and answers there, dating back years. 2. Inland or Outland Sponsorship. To the Outland Sponsorship, aka Family Class, even if you are already in Canada. There may be some who are telling you that time-wise there is not so big difference, but they are lying. There's a huge difference time-wise. You ask me how much time? My partner and I did Outland Sponsorship. It took us 4 months to get approved. Around the same time, a fellow Estonian started her Inland Sponsorship, and it took her over 10 months to get approved. That's a huge time difference. And please keep in mind that both our cases, our documents were correct. If you do Inland, you will be competing with other hundreds of thousands other citizens of other countries who are applying to the Canadian government about something to do with immigration. Outland applications, on the other hand, are processed outside of Canada, in the area where you are from. So what do you think? How many other people are applying for a Canadian permanent residence from the same place as you? Probably not so many compared with Inland. And wherever you are in the world, you can use courier to get the documents delivered to you. The goal with Outland sponsorship is to bring families together. So the process is naturally speeded up on the governmental level. Another benefit from Outland sponsorship is that during the processing time, you and your sponsor can come and leave Canada as you wish. But if you are already in Canada, you will not be able to get work permit. You will get the work permit after your application has been approved. Inland sponsorship is opposite. You and your sponsor cannot leave Canada while it's processed, but you can apply for a work permit. However, there are horror stories where some people had to wait for the Inland sponsorship more than 2.5 years. So choose wisely. 3. What you need to prove. In addition to the official documents from your country, like your birth certificate or your medical papers, you have to prove 2 main things in your application. That you and your partner, who also is your sponsor, are in mutual relationship, and that you support each other financially. Unfortunately, living together doesn't automatically mean that you are in common law relationship. Common law means that you are connected with each other financially. However, in our example, we didn't have any joint bank accounts. So what we ended up doing was that we both printed out our bank statements, and then we highlighted the areas where one of us paid for the utility and rent, and the other one paid for traveling tickets and other necessities. And it worked. 4. Organizing. Make sure that your documents are organized. Currently, Canada has created a new system for the permanent residents. Exactly what you need to send and what you don't need to send is described there in detail. When we did it according to the older application. All my official documents, all her official documents, and then the proof of our relationship, all the papers combined, were more than 500 pages. That with us, there probably were 100 other people who sent in their application at the same time. That's a lot of pile of papers. Keep in mind that at the end of the day, whoever is gonna look over your application is a human, like you and me. They don't know you. They don't know your story. And they're going to be frustrated if they have to look over piles of paper that are not organized. Make their day better so they can process your application faster. 5. Letters of support. Originally, the government requested letters of support with verified signature from at least 2 family members or friends. Letters of support means that the writer confirms that your relationship is real and they have seen it. The signature can be verified by a lawyer for a little fee. Now, the lawyer doesn't confirm the content of the text, but that the person who signs it actually exists and is not made up. Why is that so important? Like with online shopping, you're more likely to buy something that has been rated highly than something that hasn't been rated at all. Same is in this case. The more people you have who can confirm your relationship, the more convinced the authorities are that it is actually real. In the end, we sent 12 letters of support with verified signatures from our friends in Canada, Estonia, Austria, and Netherlands. Now, I'm not saying here that you should go and spend a lot of money to get the signature verified. But that being said, we believe that this over-the-top action helped convince the authorities and took away any doubt that our relationship wasn't real. 6. Look for alternative solutions. Keep an open mind. Like, what do I mean by that? Now hold on, I will explain. One of the things I read from the forums, that the people who were applying from Austria or Germany had the landlord's signature verified. As we had lived in Austria, but none of us was there anymore, it would be a huge hassle to get the landlord's signature verified and sent to us in Estonia or in Canada. But as we were officially registered in Austria, instead I contacted the Austrian embassy and got them to write a statement where they confirm that we live together in those addresses in Austria for that period of time. With that, the landlord's signature wasn't really necessary because we already confirmed on the governmental level that we lived in those addresses together. And as the paper was given by the embassy, its signature was already verified on the international scale. That's what I meant to keep an open mind. 7. Triple check your application. Keep in mind that Canada has one of the slowest progresses, or at least that is my experience. That means make sure that all the documents are out on the first go. Triple check every paper for the required signature and the check mark, and make sure that all the necessary documents are included. There is a legend that if Canada asks you for additional documents or that you made a mistake and they give you 2 months to fix it, even if you correct everything and send out on the same day, they are still going to look at it after the wait period of 2 months is over. Triple check your application. Thank you very much for watching. Check down on the description for extra links and the terms I used in this video. If you already applied for a permanent residence, let me know in the comments what time it was and how long it took you. If you didn't like the video, give it a thumbs down. If you found the video helpful, give me a thumbs up. And if you like my weird Estonian accent, subscribe as there more content is coming. And that's it. See you later.